Hello friends, I'm back with another book review, and over here I'll be discussing about Java the Complete Reference 11th edition by Herbert Smith book. So firstly I'll be talking about introduction, why we need to get this book. As you know, this is one of the most famous textbooks for learning Java. Many great programmers or even big universities like VTU have this as a prescribed textbook. The reason is programming, once you know the concepts, once you know the syntax and what kind of functionality it provides, then it becomes very easy to use it and as well as fun to code also. So this book is fully sufficient with that. It introduces every concept over here, gives examples, gives adequate theory, and at the end it'll give some practice exercise as well. So that's kind of good. Nextly, where do you need to get this book? You get it on Amazon or Sapna, Flipkart, or you can go to a college library and can take that. However, PDF copies free of costs are also available. You can go and get that. Now let's talk about the body part, as advantages and disadvantages. So the main advantage, as I can say, is every topic is well organized and it is given in very easy manner. However, sometimes you might find it difficult, but don't worry, it'll be fine once you start practicing. Its graphs are given, examples so that you can easily understand. Programs are given and then it is explained properly, so it is easy for you to follow. Then the tables are given for meaning and syntax, that is good. Java keywords, very important. And the output also, it is shown is how the output will look, and based on that it will be told how to understand the concept. So page quality is also good, the binding quality as well. Some of these concepts, if you have learned C or C++, you might be aware of it. So as we all know, Java has taken is inherited mostly all the features from C and C++, and hence you might even read redundant things like here ifs are there, nested ifs, else if ladder. The data is already there in C language as well as in C++. Going moreover, for loops, while loops also there, even do while loops are there. So if you have already learned C++, then it will be very easy to learn this. However, Java also provides us much better functionality, as we all know, so that it can work effectively in internet. And this book also explains us how to deal with files, applets and various other things. Introducing classes. Classes is one of the most important concept in Java. You can't make any Java program without learning what is a class. One hint I'll give you, or one glimpse I'll give you, that everything you write inside Java will be in the name of class, and whenever you are saving it, be it in Eclipse or a notepad, you have to save by that class name only. For example, I'll say class Java, then I have to save it java.java. The extension .java must be there. So all this book, it will explain very beautifully. However, the book doesn't prescribe any IDE, I would say. You can use any one of your wish. Now let's come to disadvantages part. So as you can see from the appearance only that this book is very fat, and most of the people who don't like reading fat books or bored of books, this might not be the best option. For them, I would suggest to read notes or read from internet. But this book really build a concept. Nextly, one main disadvantage is about the price. The price usually comes more than 500 rupees, and as a result, 500 plus. And as a result, most people are not able to afford it. It is okay, you can go with a second-hand version, or you can take it from library. Else, if you have a computer, then you can also go for PDF. That is absolutely free PDFs in internet. You can check that. However, I not recommend going with PDF because they are actually too old, means they're about 2005 and all. And as you all know, software industry keeps updating, so and hence Oracle, which has built Java, it must also keep updating itself. And another disadvantage is I found that there are no separate practice exercise that, like first I told there was practice exercise, but it's not there. You can only practice the examples, and but the examples are like enough. Means if you are trying to become a good Java programmer, then these examples are enough. You can practice and can get a hands-on experience, and you'll be good. But if you want to become some expert, means you want to work in Google, or you want to become a privately, you want to take projects and you want to execute that. For that, you need more Java programs, but you can get it from internet. That's not a worry. You can practice from internet as well. And the second kind of thing, if you get any query, then there are no options are given for asking the author or something. So as a result, you have to consult the internet or either a teacher. That is one drawback I thought. And rest of that, I think so everything is fine. This book, there are some disadvantages as well, but moreover, this good is book. Good, I mean. You can see I will be an e-book. These are the topics discussed. This keeps updating itself as it's written. But once you buy this book, you'll be very much thorough with Java, provided if you solve everything here. So this is about the disadvantages and advantages. Now let's come to conclusion. So my first suggestions about this book, I would say if you have no programming experience as well in the past, means you're not coded C, C++, HTML or anything, then the book is good for you as well. But once you learn C, C++, this will become very easy to understand. And nextly, I would say you must follow this book with a course lecture, means like either a teacher is teaching you in a college, or you're taking some online course, or even learning from other YouTube channels. Only then, because some of the concepts, I would say it is little quite tough to understand. So this is it. I hope you like my video, and please share, and if you have any comments, please write down. Thank you.